of the goodness of God. Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Yeah. Cause all my life you have been faithful. Oh, yes, you have. All my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything, oh Lord. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you
welcome back to our leadership development and administrative talk that is coming right from the Root of Cornell University. Today, we'll be looking at how to design the new product development process, that the NPD. Our teaching for today is how to design the new product development process, which is known as the NPD. Once again, my name is Professor Paul Aliu Kamara. I'm coming away from the Root of Cornell University. If you want to reach us, you can reach us through our website, www.rkuuniversity.org, one word, rkuuniversity.org. And we have our campus. This is our campus in Liberia, Monrovia to be precise, Pennsylvania. And our job is to create community of leaders. And I've been your host for the past, and I'm still your host now. Let's look at some of the things that we'll be discussing today. We'll be discussing 8 steps to success. 8 steps to success in designing your product. There are 8 steps that you need to understand, and they are very crucial on the process of developing a new product. Let's look at the content of this 8 product. First, we are looking at what is new product development. is called the NPD. What is new product development? And underneath the question, you see 8 steps of the new product process. 8 steps of the new product process. And on the 8 steps of the new product, you will see 1, idea generation, how to generate ideas. 2, you will see idea screening, how to screen your idea. 3, you will see concept development and testing. And under testing, you will see something like concept development, concept testing. There are 2 aspects of concept development and testing. You see concept development and concept testing. 4, we talk about marketing strategy development. Marketing strategy development. And 5, we're talking about business analysis. Business analysis. 6, we talk about product development. And 7, we talk about testing your product. Let us look at the introduction of today. In order to stay successful in the face of maturing product, companies need a continuous stream of new ideas successfully developed into new product. The way to obtain new product is to have a structured and a carefully executed new product development process, which is commonly known as the NPD. But companies faced problem. Everybody know that companies face problems just as human beings face problems. Although they may or they must develop new product, the odd way heavily against success. Among thousands of products entering the process at the top, only a handful eventually reach the market. So you notice there are several problems, even though there are a lot of products, but only a handful of them that can reach the market. Therefore, it is of crucial importance to understand consumers, market, and competitors in order to develop new product that delivered superior value to customer. In other words, there is no way around a systematic customer-driven new product development process for finding and growing new product. We will go into 8 major steps in new product development. First, we look at product development. What is product development? That is MPP or MPD rather. What is product development? Before jumping into the actual new product development process, let's spend a few seconds on understanding what new product development actually is. Because before you get into anything, you need to understand what it is. As always, there is a number of ways to define NPD. This also depends on the angle you take. From a marketing perspective, new product development refers to the complete process of bringing a new product to the market. The process of bringing a new product to the market. This may be a completely new product, but it may also mean renewing an existing product. In some cases, we may also refer to introducing an existing product in a new market, which usually implies to apply at least a few steps of the new product development process. As you can imagine, the MPD process looks at a bit different when looking at it from an engineering perspective. Here, the technical aspects are more emphasized, while the business implications are in the background. This means that new product development is much more focused on technical design, integrations of features, prototype, etc. Keep in mind that in a sound new product development process, both perspectives, that is marketing and engineering, are combined to develop that product or that satisfy consumers' need. That is focus of the marketing perspective in a technical superior way. Focusing on the engineering perspective. So let us look at the 8 steps of the new product development process. With a common understanding of what NDP actually is, let's now jump into the 8 steps of new product development process. Now, the new product development process is 8 step 1. We talk about idea generation, 2, idea screening, 3, concept development and testing, 4, marketing strategy development, 5, business analysis, 6, product development, 7, testing, and 8, marketing. So let's not forget that this marketing inside principles of marketing explain it all. So let's look at 1, idea generation. Idea generation. The new product development process starts with new idea generation. Idea generation refers to the systematic search for new product ideas. Typically, a company generates hundreds of ideas, maybe more, even thousands, to find a handful of good ones in the end. 2, sources of new ideas can be identified. 1 is called internal source. In the company finds new ideas internally. That means we talk about the R&D, but also contributions from employees. For instance, many companies use a so-called suggestion box, which employees can throw new ideas into. In many cases, employees are the best source of new ideas as they work with the product, but also give the feedback of customers every day. So 1, we're talking about internal source, where we can engage our staffs or departmental head or whatever source that is within that we can tap into. 2, we talk about external ideas, external sources, idea sources. In this second part, the company finds new idea externally, and this refers to all kind of external sources. Example, distributors and suppliers, but also competitors. The most important external source are customers, because the new product development process should focus on creating customers' value, collecting new product idea from customer becomes ever more important and simpler in the digital area. where the conversation between companies and customer is as interactive as never before. Active listening to customer suggestions can be a great source of innovation. And that's more the reason why it is important to listen to your customers very, very carefully. Number two, we talked about idea screening. Idea screening. The next step in the new product development process is idea screening. Idea screening means nothing else than filtering the new ideas to pick out good ones. In other words, all ideas generated are screened to spot good ones and drop poor ones as soon as possible. So you cannot invest your time, energy, and resources on an idea that does not take the company forward or means nothing to the company. While the purpose of idea generation was to create a large number of ideas, the purpose of the screening stage is to reduce that number of ideas. The reason is that product development costs rise greatly in late stage or in later stages. Companies cannot afford to take every single idea to the stages or to the next stages. Therefore, it is necessary to filter and go ahead only with those product ideas that are likely to turn into profitable product. Don't forget, in our previous teaching, we spoke about business as a profit-making venture and at the same time, a problem-solving platform. Therefore, it is necessary to filter and go ahead only with those product ideas that are likely to turn into profitable product. Dropping the poor ideas as soon as possible is consequently of crucial importance. At this early stage, filtering for the potentially profitable idea can be tricky. A key to success is to initiate the conversation with customer earlier and look for feedback, for instance, by surveys and focus group interview. Company can have small scale discussions, meetings, engagement. Company can get early insight whether their ideas might meet customer demand in a better way than the existing product. Number three, we look at concept development and testing. To go on in the new product development process, attractive idea must be developed into a product concept. A product concept is a detailed version of the new product idea stated in meaningful customer test. You should distinct the following sub stages. One, a product idea. One is a product idea. This is really just an idea for a possible product. Two, a product concept. Two, a product concept. This is a detailed version of the idea stated in meaningful consumer terms. Number three, a product image. This is the way consumer perceive an actual or potential product. Concept development and testing is a crucial stage in the new product development process. Therefore, let's go into the two sub-stages in detail. One, concept development. One, concept development. Now, imagine a car manufacturer that has developed an all-electronic cars That is a BEV. The idea has passed the idea screening stage and must now be developed into a concept. The marketer's task is to develop this new product into a number of alternative product concepts. Then the company can find out how attractive each concept is to consumer and choose the best one. A product concept should at least capture the realization or form the product will take. A product concept should at least capture the realization or formed the product or form the product will take. The target group it caters to, as well as the main use cases. Possible product concept for the electrical or the electric car ideas could be one. Concept one, an affordable price, mid-size car, designed as a second family car or to be used around town for visiting friends and ongoing shoppings. So it depends what model that you come out or up with. Number two concept could be a mid-price sporty compact car appealing to young single and couples for fun, you know, rides in their free time. Number three concept can be a high-end mid-size utility vehicle or van appealing to those who like the space SUVs provides, but also want, you know, economical car for everyday use in the city. As you can see, this concept needs to be quite precise in order to be meaningful. So let's look at the next sub concept, whether the concept of testing. The concept of testing. New product concepts such as those given above need to be tested with a group of target consumers. The concept can be presented to consumer either symbolically or physically. The question is always, does the particular concept have strong consumer appeal? For some concept tests, a word or picture description might be sufficient. However, to increase the reliability of the test, a more concrete and physical presentation of product concepts may be needed. After exposing the concept to the group of target consumers, these will be asked to answer questions in order to find out the consumer appeal and consumer value of each concept. At the end of the concept testing stage, you should have a clear idea of which product concept is the best in terms of consumers' feedback. In some cases, it may be that several concepts seem to work great. For instance, two different versions may prove to cater well to two different sub-target groups, provided each of the target group provides a sufficient large and relevant target market. The company may also choose to go ahead with both product concept. Number four, we talk about marketing strategy development. Marketing strategy development. The next step in the new product development process is the marketing strategy development. When a promising concept has been developed and tested, it is time to design an initial marketing strategy for the new product based on the product concept for introducing this new product to the market. The marketing strategy statement consists of three parts and should be formulated carefully. One, a description of the target market, the planned value proposition, and the sales, market shares, and profit goal for the first few years. Number two, an outline of the product plan price, distribution and marketing budgets for the first year. Number three, the plan long-term sales, profit goal, and the marketing mixed strategy. Number five, business analysis. Number five, business analysis. Once the company has described upon, or once the company has decided upon a product concept and marketing strategy, management can evaluate the business attractiveness of the proposed new product. The fifth step in the new product development process involves a review of the sales, cost, and profit projection for the new product to find out whether these factors satisfy the company's objective. If they do, the product can be moved on to the product development stage. In order to estimate sales, the company could, for instance, look at the sales history of similar products and conduct market surveys, having a precise view of the likely demand for the eventually product is absolutely crucial. There are countless cases wherein this stage was underestimated. For example, think of cars that turn out to be flops when introduced to the market. Often companies tend to skip this stage or spend too much little time on it. The reason is, in many cases, a bias to focus too much on the company perspective rather than listening to customers. When you come up with a new idea, think it through. Design the product. Include all those features you like and so on. You may have developed a great product for yourself. However, this does not mean that it would be a great product for the market. Customer feedback is therefore a critical element along all stages of the new product development processes. Once the initial demand analysis has been estimated, the company should be able to estimate minimum and maximum sales to assess the range of risk. Based on the sales forecast, the company should estimate the expected cost and profit for our product, including marketing, R&D, operation, etc. All the sales and cost figures together can eventually be used to analyze the new product financial attractions. Number six, we talk about product. Number six, we talk about product development. Product development. The new product development process goes on with the actual product development. Up to this point, for many new product concepts, there may be exist or there maybe exists only a word description, a drawing, or perhaps a rough prototype. But if the product concept passes the business test, it must be developed into a physical product to ensure that the product idea can be turned into a workable market offering. The problem is, though that at this stage, R&D and engineering cost cause a huge jump in investment. The R&D development department will develop and test one or more physical versions of the product concept. Developing a successful prototype, however, can take days, weeks, months, or even years, depending on the product and prototype methods. Also, products often undergo tests to make sure they perform safely and effectively. So this can be done by the firm itself or outsource. In many cases, markets involve actual customers in product testing. Consumers can evaluate prototypes and work with pre-release product. Their experience may be very useful in the product development stage. Finally, number seven, or almost finally, number seven. Testing market. This is the area where the market can be tested. The last stage, therefore, or before commercialization, is test marketing. In this stage of the new product development process, the product and its proposed marketing program are tested in realistic market settings. Therefore, test marketing gives the marketer experience with marketing the product before going to the great expenses of full introduction. In fact, it allows the company to test the product and its entire marketing program, including targeting and positioning strategy, advertising, distribution, packaging, etc., before the full investment is made. The amount of test marketing necessary varies with each new product. Especially when introducing a new product that requires a large investment, when the risks are higher, or when the firm is not sure of the product or its marketing program, a significant amount of time may be spent on testing. Finally, number eight. Commercialization. Number eight is commercialization. Test marketing has given management the information needed to make the final decision: launch or do not launch the product. The final stage in the new product development process is commercialization. The commercialization means nothing else than introducing a new product into the market. At this point, the highest costs are incurred. The company may need to build or rent a manufacturing facility. Large amount may be spent on advertising, sales, production, and other marketing effort in the first year. Some factors should be considered before the product is commercialized. Number one, introduction time. For instance, if the economy is down, it might be wise to wait until the following year to launch the product. However, if competitors are ready to introduce their own product, the company should push to introduce the new product. But look at the first advice. For instance, if the economy is down, you might be wise to wait Because no one can buy a product when the economy is down, except some product that has to do with the easing of the economic pressure or burden. Number two, introduction place. You need to know where to launch the new product. Should it be launched in a single location, a region, a national market, or an international market? In many cases, companies may lack the confident capital and capacity to launch new products into full international distribution from the start. Instead, they will usually develop a plan marketing which rolls out over time. Now, as we close, in all other steps, or in all of these steps of the new product development process, the most important focus is on creating superior customer value. Only when or only then the product can become a success in the market. As you can imagine, only very few products actually get the chance to become success. The risk and cost are simply too high to allow every product to pass every stage of the new product development process. Given this risk and cost, it is of crucial importance to get this new stage or this new 8 steps of the new product to be tested and followed up with. So this is the end of our lesson today. I'm very sure that you have gained a lot in the process of how to initiate and run a new product development process. I've been your coach or instructor or tutor or lecturer. My name is Professor Paul Aliyu Kamara, coming to you right away from the road of Cornell University, an associate professor of leadership development and administration. Our job is to create the leadership in the business world, in the public sector, and by extension, in government, and to help develop nations. Rudolf Cornell University is one of the fastest growing universities, fully accredited by the International Association for Quality Assurance in Higher Education in the United States, the body that is responsible to accredit universities. And our parent university is the California University that is in Delaware in California. We have been, which has been in operation for 164 years. And we are also partners to Ballsbridge University, an international global interfaith university, and the International University for Management and Administration in Benin Republic, the 10th best universities in Benin. Log into our website, www.rudolfcornelluniversity.org. If you want to email me, my email is profrku24@gmail.com. Thank you for being there, and I will join you again tomorrow with another topic, another teaching. Thank you so much.